Well, dozens of washouts, hundreds of swift water rescues, and powerful images of Vermont's capital city buried and under mud and debris.
Until Monday, Tropical Storm Irene was the threshold for the worst flooding our region had seen in recent memory. Now, as the high water drains and communities pick up the pieces, it raises the question, how soon could we experience something like this again?
NBC5's Adrian Pastore joins us live from Montpelier with an outlook from a climatologist on the changing weather patterns. Adrian?
Yeah, Sarah Beth Zuri, this historic damage that we're seeing across the region has certainly raised a lot of questions about climate change and the risk for flash flooding. These past heavy rainfall came in spanning days, and this is the result here. Take a look at what we're seeing right now. We're just outside of Hugo's Bar and Grill, where you can see there's a ton of debris out there. We also have a line of cars that have come within the last 20 minutes or so to come scoop that up and start cleaning out what's left on the curb here. But we spoke with experts who tell us that this isn't the last time we'll see events like these.
Whether it's a blizzard or a hurricane, whenever a system slows down, it actually has the ability to sort of rain itself out or snow itself out in that space that it slowed out over, which means higher precipitation totals.
Widespread heavy rainfall totaling 7 to 9 inches in some parts of our region and causing catastrophic flash flooding comparable to Tropical Storm Irene, possibly the most significant flood in recent memory until now.
Irene lasted about 24 hours. It was raining one day, it was a Sunday afternoon, and then I think it was Monday. We woke up, the sun was shining, and we went out to look at the damage, and we were able to get to work immediately. This is going on, and we are getting just as much rain, if not more, and it's going on for days.
A rainstorm pre-climate change would not have dumped in some places 9 inches of rain, but all of that moisture in the air gets turned into rain that then gets added to the volume, which is enormous.
According to the EPA, our warming oceans increase the amount of water that evaporates in the air, producing heavier rain and snowstorms, leading to devastation in our region.
The processes and the wind flows, these storm systems are also expanding in their range as our climate continues to change. Floods, droughts, tornadoes, hail, severe weather, thunderstorms, lightning, all of those are hazards. And then once it produces a lot of loss, like unfortunate loss of either life or property, then it becomes a disaster.
This most recent disaster, one that will go down in history for cities like Montpelier. But if there's one thing our neighbors have taken away from all of this, it's how to be there for one another.
By the time I got down here, I had like 12 people in here, and stuff moved out and everyone was mopping. And I didn't even ask for their help. I'm like blown away.
Now, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration predicts that flash flooding and disastrous floods could occur 5 times more than they do now by the year 2050. But that number is an average depending on things like the terrain. Now, how does that affect Vermont and New York? That mainly impacts those mountainous towns that are located near streams and rivers, which could be at higher risk if we do see those changing climate patterns continue. We're live in Montpelier this morning. Adrian Pastore, NBC5 News.